You know, Robin, we haven't talked about the best of the worst. In what other league is the worst team as intriguing as the best team? Well, two very intriguing teams that are not expected to do much are the Knicks and the Lakers. Let's open this up to Rohan and Jared. Also, if you're betting on the future of these two teams, if you're buying stock in one of them, I guess, Rohan, who would you choose?
I think you got to take the Lakers, right? I mean, why not? They got, you know, that young piece in Lonzo Ball. They got the free agent recruiter in Magic Johnson, also in the Twitter Hall of Fame. I think the big thing for the Lakers right now is they'll probably have that possibility to create a lot of cap space next summer. And guys want to play there. I mean, Paul George, a lot of guys seem to want to play there. So I think you got to take the Lakers.
Jared.
Yeah, Lakers too. A lot of cap space, like Ron mentioned. Lonzo Ball, you want a great point guard on your team. Jordan Clarkson, Brandon Ingram looks very good in the preseason. Got the cool new hair going. Has a great new flavor to his game. Yeah, Kyle Kuzma. I texted CJ McCollum yesterday. I was doing an NBA fantasy league. I said, who is your sleeper pick in fantasy? He said, Kyle Kuzma. So watch this kid, second round pick. Had a great showing in Vegas Summer League. So I take the Lakers. I think they have a lot of star buzz. And when you have Lonzo running the ship there, they're going to play very fast. Defense will be a big question, but they're young. A lot of good pieces around Magic and Rob Pelinka building that team up. And could they get Paul George next year? We'll see.
Situation-wise, I might take the Knicks. The Lakers have sort of been Knicks West over the last several years, and both teams putting on their little film productions to bring in free agents, and they never come. Porzingis has already proven himself to a certain degree in the league. Hardaway Jr., I kind of like that signing. Most didn't. They're going to get their draft pick this year, but I can't pick the Knicks because of management. At least Lakers have new management. Luke Walton, a young coach who's had success, and the Knicks have won one playoff series since I graduated from high school, so how can I really go with them?
I got to go with you guys. You can't pick the Knicks. It's a total dysfunction, dumpster fire, all the things that we've been calling them for the last decade or so. You have Jeff Hornacek on the hot seat. We don't even know if he's a good coach. The Phil Jackson experiment was just a burning flames of, I don't know, high school science experiments have gone better than Phil Jackson, and we're probably a little less expensive. Well, so I'm going to go with
the Lakers. Let me ask you guys, looking into your crystal ball, do you think Porzingis is even on the Knicks 4 years from now?
I do, because I think they're going to pay him. I mean, I still think that he's going to – he's so ingratiated in the fan base here, and I think he's going to do the mellow where he, like, wants to win in New York, and they're going to be able to offer more than anybody, and why wouldn't you take it?
You know, the biggest hindrance for Porzingis' career is probably playing for the Knicks.